never spoken, Inger Miller's dream, to win a gold medal, the only medal her father Lennox never won.
I think she was very fortunate because she had people who had been there, you know, and the interchange between Donald and myself was very good. I mean, we never argued over anything. We certainly didn't agree on everything, but, you know, we were able to compromise and say, okay, let's do this, see if it works. If it doesn't, then we go to plan B.
All right, just cover the curve well, and then you see where you are and keep driving.
So she had a team that was totally on her side, wasn't doing it for the money, wasn't doing it for the recognition, but just, we were there just to help her. And I think she felt that.
It's unique, but we're happy that that's the situation, because what we are able to pass on to Inger is that competitive drive, the inside part of track and field that is not seen by the average person. The concentration, the determination, how do you prepare to deal with your competitors at different levels? Because when you're competing in the Olympics, it's like a big race each time. You're not effective unless you make the finals.
The preliminary and quarterfinal rounds for the 200 meters are scheduled for July 31st, with the semifinal and final to take place the following day. Inger Miller, third from the left, methodically passes her first tests, finishing in the top four in each of her qualifying heats. In both races, the winner is Marie-José Perec of France, who was the near unanimous favorite to win the gold medal.
She did well. She was back off.
After each race, she would return to the practice track for massages, ice baths, and then again, the endless wind sprints. Then she would relax and watch the events at the nearby Olympic Stadium. Tonight, it's Dionne Hemmings of Jamaica winning the women's 400-meter hurdles. The next day, the semifinals. Inger Miller in lane 7 on the extreme left qualifies for the final by finishing fourth. Again, the winner is Marie-José Perec of France.